Hey guys, today we'll learn about combinations and permutations and two different types that each can have. But first we need to define what a combination is and what a permutation is. And a combination is a selection of items from a set where the order does not matter. Whereas with the permutations, order is important and is something that we need to factor in. We'll start by talking about permutations without repetition. Here I have three cards, the Jack, the Queen, and the King of Spades. Now the question is, how many ways are there to arrange those cards? To answer it, we need to consider what happens every time we draw a card. The first time, we have all three cards available to us. However, in the second draw, we only have two cards available and only one on the last third draw. Mathematically, we can represent that with a factorial, where we multiply 3 by 2 and by 1. And what we get is 6, so there's a total of 6 permutations that are possible with those three cards. Let's consider a different question. What if we had 5 cards and we wanted to draw only 3? Now, the answer is not 5 factorial since we have only 3 cards that are drawn, and on the first draw we have 5 cards available, on the second we have 4, and on the third we have 3. So there's still 2 and 1 that we need to take care of. So to make the number accurate, we are going to put the 5 factorial in the denominator, and we're going to put 2 multiplied by 1, or 2 factorial, in the denominator. And that gives us the accurate answer. So we have 60 possible permutations. Now, the general formula looks like this. NPR equals n factorial, where n is the total number of items in our set, and r is the number of items that we are going to draw. Next, we have permutations with repetition. Those are a little easier than the ones without repetition, and the formula is a bit more straightforward, but since we're trying to consider all possibilities, let's take a look. So here we have three balls, green, blue, and yellow. We're going to draw a random ball out of those three consecutive times. And the difference between the permutations without repetitions and the ones with is that, in this case, whenever we draw, the range of our possibilities remains the same. So mathematically, what that looks like is 3 multiplied by 3 and multiplied by 3. Or, if we consider R to be the number of draws and N the number of items that we're drawing from, we can express the formula as N to the power of R. And so, in our case here, N equals 3 and R equals 3, so there's a total of 9 possible permutations. Now we're going to discuss combinations. And the thing about combinations is that, unlike the permutations, the order doesn't really matter. And first we're going to look at combinations without repetitions, since they are a little easier to wrap your head around. And let's go back to our example with the cards. We just figured out that 3 cards can have 6 possible permutations without repetition. However, if we take a look at those permutations, there's a thing that doesn't change. It's just different arrangements of the same cards, the King, the Jack, and the Queen. And in terms of combinations, there's only one. There may be 6 permutations, but it's still the same cards being shuffled. So let's ask a slightly different question. How many 2-card combinations can we draw from 3 cards? If we consider the possibilities, we realize that there are only 3. It's the King and Queen, the King and the Jack, and Jack and the Queen. So mathematically, what that is going to look like if n is the number of items and r is the size of each combination is this. we get this formula, which is very common in mathematics, as well as statistics in particular. And you read it like this. The NCR is read as N choose R, where, as I've said before, N is the number of items and R is the size of each combination, the number of items you're going to draw. And it looks, well, a little bit all too familiar, right? So it's just like the formula for permutations without repetition. However, we are also multiplying this formula by 1 over r factorial to get rid of, you know, the repetitions. So we eliminate the queen and king, and king and queen are going to become the same thing. And we eliminate those similarities to leave only the combinations. Last but not least, we have to consider combinations with repetition. And I'll be honest, when it was first explained to me, it took me a while to really understand what's going on. However, once you do, it's nothing short of mathematical magic. So let's start by asking a question that is a variation of a different question we just discussed. How many two-card combinations can we draw from three cards, however, this time with repetition? To answer that, we'll start by drawing a table. Here we have a table with three columns where each column represents a type of card, the Jack, the King, and the Queen that we've seen before, and each row represents a particular combination. So in the first row we have two Jacks, in the second row we have a King and a Queen, and a Jack and a Queen in the third row. If you look at this table, you can actually see that there's a way to simplify and make it more abstract. And it's going to look something like this. See, in this kind of coded language, we can express into which bin or which column every particular item we draw goes. And by arranging those X's and those lines in a particular fashion, we can figure out how many items of a particular category we have and thus determine what combination this is. So if you're starting to realize where this is going, brilliant, because this is the part that took me a long while to wrap my head around. And what we do next is we put those axes and those lines in their own distinct cells. It helped me to number them to really see what's going on. And what you have, those numbers, are actually their own set from which we can draw. And that means we can make combinations with it, right? So for example, what you see here is a combination of 1 and 4. If you took the axis or if you took the lines, it's a combination of 2 and 3. So we start to see that every particular combination here corresponds to a particular combination in our original problem. So X line line X would mean that there's one Jack, no King, and one Queen. In essence, we just took a complicated question and asked a slightly simpler one, one that we know how to answer. And the question is, how many ways are there to arrange the axes and the lines in those four cells? And yep, you got it right. This is a question about combinations without repetition, since every cell has its particular number assigned to it. So the mathematical answer to it looks like this. It's 4 choose 2. That equals to 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial and 4 minus 2 factorial, which gives you 24 over 4, or a total of 6 possible combinations. And the 6 combinations of X's in those 4 cells is actually the 6 possible combinations of cards that you can have if you draw 2 from a stack of 3. Let that sink in. The question wasn't answered directly. Rather, we took a sidetrack to simplify what we were asked and then give a direct answer to the problem through an indirect solution. Here's the general formula for combinations with repetition. And you can see that it looks quite similar to the formula for combinations without repetition, except in this case, we substitute the n in our original formula with r plus n minus 1, where r is the number of items in a combination, n is the total number of categories those items can belong to, and n minus 1 is the number of our abstract dividers. So for example, in case of our problem, we have two cards per combination, so R equals 2, the N equals 3, and there are two dividers separating the three categories, so N minus 1 equals 2. Notice that the formula is the same for R plus N minus 1 choose R, as well as R plus N minus 1 choose N minus 1. This is because the problem is symmetrical. We only need to place the dividers to know where the x's are, or only place the x's to know where the dividers are. So there you go.
Don't forget to subscribe and check out other videos for related topics.